my channel. If you're new here, welcome. So today I'm going to be doing my 2018 holiday wrap up. This is going to be a relatively quick video. It is honestly just recapping the videos that I did for the 12 days of Festive Xmas and kind of talking about my favorites. So favorite to edit, favorite special effects, and favorite beauty makeup looks. So anyways, without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. So first we're actually going to be talking about my favorite look to edit, and I actually have two for that because one of them was definitely just like I had a lot of fun choosing the music for it, and then the other I had a lot of fun really kind of getting into the editing and trying to line everything up so it looked perfect. So the first one was my 11 makeup tutorial. Now that kind of seems weird because, you know, it's just a basic makeup look, but I had so much fun editing that just because there were so many amazing Stranger Things themed covers that I could choose from, and so it was really fun to kind of just go through and figure out which one sounded best. I got a lot of opinions from other people because sometimes it just depends on the look you're going for or the sound, and so I ended up finding one that I felt like fit it absolutely perfectly, but it was a lot of fun to kind of, you know, play around with that, and I had more fun doing that than I do maybe the average video. And my second favorite video to edit was my clock-inspired makeup look from the last 5 years. One main reason being that I'm just absolutely obsessed with the last 5 years, and so editing this one specifically as opposed to editing Shmuel was definitely very different. Shmuel was kind of easy because I already had the music picked out for him months ago because I had already been doing the research for that. But for the clock, I just had an idea in my head that I wanted to definitely have like the clock bells ringing in the background before it like swoops in to some normal music, and I fell in love with this. I decided to insert some clips from the movie into it, and it was just a lot of fun to put together, and I spent a lot more time on it, and I just really enjoyed how it turned out. And that is why it is one of my favorite videos for 12 Days of Festive Xmas. The next one was my favorite beauty makeup look, and if we can really think about it, it is 12 Days of Festive Xmas, and I did incorporate a few more beauty makeup looks into this than I would normally, simply because it's like, oh, I added body paint freckles, that makes it special effects, even though it really doesn't, but it did seem to fit the theme because of the overall character that I created for it, I guess. So there isn't really much to choose from, and we're also choosing from a category of 12 makeup looks, some of them not even being in the beauty category because they're just, you know, full-on prosthetics. But my favorite beauty makeup look that I did this year was actually my melted candle makeup look that I did. This was inspired by the song My Christmas Tree from Home Alone 2, where they're all holding their little candlesticks and singing, and I just had the image come into my mind of doing a melted candle from that scene and have like a wreath on the head to represent the Christmas tree, and I absolutely loved how it turned out. It was so much fun. It looked 1,000 times better than I actually could have imagined it looking, so I was really happy that I was actually able to translate it onto makeup. And last but not least is my favorite special effects makeup look, and I feel like it's pretty obvious simply because it is the largest special effects makeup look for 12 Days of Xmas, but it is my Shmuel makeup tutorial. Like I said before, I'm obsessed with the last 5 years, so the reason that this actually fits into 12 Days of Xmas, because why would a clock makeup tutorial or an old man fit into 12 Days of Xmas? Like, how is it Christmas themed? Well, the reason for that is because whenever he's telling this story, it is Christmas time, and he's using Christmas decorations to fully explain the story to Kathy because it's their first Christmas together, and he wants to kind of help motivate her a little bit more. The only downside to Shmuel that I realized more so after the fact when I was looking at the footage was I wasn't that big of a fan of how his nose turned out. It looked a lot better in person, but on camera it doesn't seem to translate as well as it looked in person. You definitely see a lot more of the details and the mistakes. So something I'm actually going to be trying to do in the future is trying a different way of sculpting prosthetics to try to make them look more realistic. Now of course you could do the full-blown movie mode prosthetics where you make molds for them. I'm going to try to avoid that if possible, simply because that is such a large task, and that is personally not my favorite thing to do. I like making the prosthetics, but I don't like spending that much time and effort making the prosthetics. So I'm actually going to be trying something new in the future. Actually, the very near future. It's going to be coming up within the next week. And so I'm going to be trying a different way of sculpting and producing the prosthetics. So hopefully, fingers crossed, they look more realistic. If it doesn't work out, y'all will probably never find out about it. So anyways, that is mostly it for this video. Like I said, very short video, but I mostly just wanted to showcase all of the looks I did for this year's 12 Days of Xmas, because I personally think it's really cool to see it all together, because for me it's really easy to forget some of the looks I did just because there's so many and they all happen at once, and so it's kind of easy to lose track of all of them. And it's really interesting to see which of these are your favorites, so please feel free to comment down below which 12 Days of Xmas look is your favorite, because I think it's really interesting how everyone just has different interests and which ones resonated with some people more than others. Also, before I go, I did just want to let you guys know that whenever I do hit 1,000 1,000 subscribers, I am going to be doing a little bit of a giveaway for you guys. So if you're not, please feel free to subscribe. If you don't want to, it's totally fine. We'll get there someday. I really have no way of gauging when I'm going to hit that milestone simply because there's no real way for me to know when I'm gonna get subscribers or not. So we're kind of playing it all by ear. I just wanna let you guys know that that is a plan. Whenever I get to that point, I do want to thank you guys because you have been with me through so much. It's almost been 2 years and 6 months, so it's basically just been a year and a half, but still, it's been a long time. We've been through over 200 videos together, and so it's really just fun to have you guys grow with me, and it means a lot to me, so I wanna be able to thank you for that. So anyways, with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Leave a comment down below what you'd like to see next. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to my channel so you can see more of my videos, because I have so many fun videos planned for the upcoming week that you guys are going to be absolutely in love with if you're a nerd like me. So anyways, I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!